not gonna lie to you. This TNA series has been stressful. Jeff Hardy is on the shelf. CM Punk is on the shelf. Adam Cole, baby, is on the shelf. Ali was on the shelf for a long time. Ricochet was on the shelf. Rebel was on the shelf. Sure, we got broken Matt Hardy now, but with all those injuries, I mean, and rehabs, you gotta assume the game is out to get me. But there's no challenge that I can't face, you know? As long as I got the people that I need, as long as I got, you know, guys like Kurt Angle and guys like Cody Rhodes and Okada, Broken Matt, as long as I got them, I'll be fine. So we're just going to have a chill episode. It's going to be episode 63. Welcome to episode 63 of our EWR TNA. So we're going to take a deep breath and we're going to enjoy the show. Or the game's gonna screw us over again, you know. Either way, it works. Alright, hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. Welcome back properly to the episode. The Rock is injured. Because why not? It's the second time he'll be out in the 63 episodes that have comprised this series. So, yeah, we have no option here but to say, okay, he's injured. Let's see how long he'll be out for. In 2 months, so he'll be out for the rest of September. He'll be out for October. He will be back beginning of November. So that will put a damper on the card. So this will change. So Kurt Angle will now be facing Hiroshi Tanahashi. Whoops. Which sucks. I mean, it doesn't suck. It's going to be a great match either way. But that's not the match that I had in mind, you know. I had Angle versus Rock, and Hiroshi Tanahashi would be doing something else. But you know, I guess I don't have much of a choice now. I'm gonna have to do that. We're still on Monday, so we have 2 days to go until Explosion. We're still looking over who AAA and ECA, the new company, is signing. So you know, just the independent guys. Okay. I just want to check something real quick. Tama Tonga. You know what? Written. I'll steal Tama Tonga. There we go. I'll steal Tama Tonga, and while I'm at it, what was his name? Dang it, now I gotta look it up. Sophie. Tevita. Tevita. No? Huh. Camacho. Alteri. Can't remember his name either. I mean, Hunico is Sin Cara right now, yeah? Oh my god. What is going on here? Like, Hunico Sin Cara. Here, right? You know what? I'm not gonna mess with it. I was gonna sign Gorillas of I forgot what the D stands for. Don't take that out of context, please. Tama Tonga, where are you? Tama Tonga. He's a lightweight, so I'm probably going to send him to Explosion. I will look at the lower mid carders first. Everyone, Lormit Carter's Impact, pretty even. Explosion, they need one more heal to be even, so we're gonna send him to Explosion. Gorillas of Destiny with Tangaloa. Why did he not show up? Is he with NWA? No. Is he with DCA? Yes. Do I want him though? I think I do. Oh. Did I not hire the Revival? Did I forget to hire the Revival? Whoops. I can sign them now though. Wait, let me check if I can sign both. Other workers. Scott Dawson. Sign both. Sign them. Heel written. Written. Yeah. Two more. Fine, more. Jesus Christ. Who else? I don't think there's anybody else that I want to send right now. Roster. Search criteria. Now we go to everyone who isn't in a roster split, which is Wilder and Dawson. And they'll be both going to Impact. Whoops. Impact, yeah. Quickly check the heel face divide. Can I check like just wrestlers? Apparently I can't. Impact. This is even. Two more heels. Even. Two more heels, one more heel. So we're actually gonna have the Revival come in as baby faces and change their names. Scott Dawson. Let's see other names for Scott Dawson. What else has he used? He used to use Casey McKnight. So Scott McKnight. That's his new name, Scott McKnight. And we're gonna let Dash Wilder go back to be Steven Walters. Because we have Matthias Wild. I don't remember his name already, so Wild and Wilder sort of sounds like a competition, so he's gonna go back to being Steven Walters. There we go. Make change. Alright. McKnight, and let me activate their team. Oh, they're activated. Cool. Alright, we got the Revival of the Shatter Machine. And they are both on Impact, yeah? Steven. Impact. Got Impact. A face. Face. They're both gonna come in as faces because we need a new face team, because there's two more heels, and those two more heels are the Dudley Boys. So we're gonna bring them in as faces. Yeah. And today's the show, so let's just go over these. Nikki Bella was still unemployed. That's amazing. Okay, so let's do our show. So this explosion. Yeah, I do have the right one. I was worried there for a second. This explosion. So we can see the debut of Tama Tonga. He will be coming in as Tama Tonga. Explosion. So Noam Dar is our only jobber on Explosion. I can't believe I said Noam Dar is our jobber. It's a weird sentence. So we're gonna have a bit of a UK team up as Andrews, Ospreay, and Dar team up against Kenny Omega, Tama Tonga, and No other Bullet Club member on Explosion. Shoot. Isn't Kenny Omega in a feud actually? Feuds. Hey, against Carlito. Okay, we're gonna fix that then. It's gonna be Carlito, Osprey, and Andrews. Dar will be taken off the match because he's lower down the card. Versus Tama Tonga, Kenny Omega, and I didn't think this through. I did not think this through. Wait, Chavo's gonna. No, I'm gonna leave that for another one. Explosion. And Tyler Wilde, you know what? Why not? He's a good wrestler. He does the wrestling good. So we're gonna do a match. A 3v3 match. Tag, yeah. So it's Carlito. That's not how you spell Carlito. Carlito, Mark and Will versus Kenny Omega, Tama Tonga, and honorary Bullet Club member Tyler Wilde. That's his first name. I thought it was Matthias because he was Matt Wilde for a while there, but he stopped being that and started being something else. Because it is his debut, he will be on the winning side. So yeah, it's that. Kenny Omega cleanly. He won't get the pin because like Carlito is way above him in the overness scale, but he will be on the winning side. We start the show with an angle. It's actually gonna be just like at an angle. I meant to say interview. An interview. Single worker. AJ Lee, and she's gonna be mocking, if I can, The Rock. By the way, the artiste is the new name of Aiden English. He was gonna be Matthew English, but with Matt Hardy and Matt Jackson and Matt something else, there's a third Matt, whose name it eludes me, Matt Murphy. I figured it was too many mats for one show, so he's the artiste now. She's gonna mock The Rock for being injured because he mocked CM Punk for going to rehab, I believe. And after that, we have an actual angle, yeah. An ambush angle, yeah. And that's the actual proper debut of Tama Tonga. As Tama Tonga and Kenny Omega attack Carlito. And that explains the heel side winning. Not that it needs explaining. Next up, we have. Wow. Nikki Storm. Versus. Okay, Nikki Storm and Rebel versus Taylor Hendricks and Athena. Seems like a proper good match. So it's Taylor Hendricks and Athena versus Nikki Storm and the returning Rebel. There we go. For another championship. And Taylor Hendricks gets the win over on Rebel. Because I do not give a rat's ass for Rebel. Nothing against her personally. I don't care about her. Zarya brawl to the back. No, whoops. No aftermath. Just try to put Taylor Hendricks over. And after that, we go up to the lower mid-carders of Explosion. We're gonna do Caprice Coleman. Wait. Caprice Coleman and Cedric Alexander taking on. TJP and Brian Kendrick. But that's not next. The next one will be a One view, one angle. Returning. Attack. See? Returning to attack. And this? She is a heel, so she's not gonna come back with the ditzy gimmick. Cause I hate that gimmick, honestly. So she's gonna come back as like, well, kind of like how she was when she was Cherry Bomb in the Indies. So that's sort of, you know, she comes back tough as nails, just wanting to kick people's ass, trying to make more Rosemary's out there. So yeah. That's the return of Valley. I'm on Explosion, not on Impact. That's how Ally returns. Like Rich Swann versus Tommy End could be a good match. We're gonna do that. I'm just testing out matches to see who could get a little push to the main event. Obviously, Tommy End is en route to getting, you know, a main event run because I like his work. I'm a huge fan of Tommy End. Aleister Black, for those who only know his WWE name, gotta get used to using that now. Tommy End wins, obviously. Cleanly. The aftermath is a something. You know what? No aftermath, really. Just put Tommy End over. That's all I ask of life in general. Now, after that, we got the tag team match that I was saying. I might create some Explosion tag team championships, or maybe X Division tag team championships. Or maybe I'll make the the tag team championships cross brand, because I had that idea. Because, you know, rather than overload both brands with tag teams and have really weak and really strong tag teams, I'll just, you know, build tag teams on one brand and then have a cross brand event where they might take the championships, and at the same time that will prevent people from you know, getting overexposed, because if I split them up, you know, people can see the tag teams on one show and see the tag teams on another show. They don't get like I don't know what I'm saying, but it makes sense in my head. And that's all that matters. Today's TJ Ryan, not Braxton, Ryan, Coleman and Alexander versus Kendrick and Perkins. If I were to make them cross-brand, probably Kendrick and Perkins would take the championships, because they've been teaming for a while. They got great chemistry. Ryan wins. Priest, because I like Cedric more than I like Priest. So I tend to protect Cedric, and also Cedric's a cool name, I like it. Not cleanly though, no. I'll protect him by cheating. They brawl to the back, cause they like to add insult to injury, and they just keep fighting. Put on a good match, really. Okay, what other feuds on this show? This one is currently dead, so it will not go on. But I do have Kenta vs. Chavo and Rebecca Knox vs. Alicia Crawford. So we're going to have ourselves an angle. A 1v1 angle. Sneak attack. As, forgot what I was doing. It's Chavo, there we go, attacks Kenta. Jesus Christ, I had a brain fart. I don't like that expression. Chavo attacks Kenta. We're on a slow burn for that one. So that's all that's gonna happen for that feud. Rebecca Knox versus Alicia Crawford. Actually, Chao versus Kenta. Yeah. Explosion and Inventors. So we're gonna say that Chavo attacked Kenta because Kenta was gonna team up with Rey Mysterio to take on Jushin and Chavo. But now it's going to be in the main event of the evening. Rey Mysterio taking on Chavo Guerrero and Jushin Liger. And Rey Mysterio will be having a surprise tag team partner in the shape of Ricochet, the returning Ricochet, coming back from injury. For no championship, select the result. Rey Mysterio wins over Chavo by interference as Kenta comes back to get some payback on Chavo Guerrero. And Mysterio and Ricochet celebrate. The purpose is to continue the feud. Okay, so that's that. How is the Knox Crawford feud? It's 2-2. So we're gonna have ourselves. Hold on. Need to quickly. Main event. Upper Midcarders. Explosion. So Knox is right there. Ashley Flair's right here. We're gonna have Kana. Are we gonna have Kana? No, we're gonna have Natalia. Natalia versus Brittany Knight versus Alicia Crawford versus Tennille. And the winner will be the number one contender for elimination. Natalia and Brittany Knight will be the number one contender for Rebecca Knox's TNA Knockouts Championship. Alicia Crawford and who was it? Oh man, my mind is not okay. It wasn't Jade. It wasn't Maria. Tennille. It was Tennille. Keep forgetting. For no championship, that's the knockouts. The first winner will be Natalia. The second winner will be Tennille. The only winner will be Alicia. The first elimination will be Natalia. The second elimination will be Tennille. The final elimination will be Brittany Knight. Finish by cheating. And after that, we get a neat little segment where Alicia, post-win, gets a microphone and taunts Rebecca to hype their match, but also to continue their feud. And let's start this show. So AJ Lee is backstage. She talks trash about The Rock for an 89 rating. Cool. Tama Tonga gains over us from attacking Carlito Colon alongside Kenny Omega. The six-man tag team match gets a 67 rating, a 40. Let's not talk about that 40. A 40 for Hendrix and Athena versus Nikki Storm and Rebel. All right. Candice LeRae and Allie gain overness from the return of Allie as Allie gets hit with the best super kick ever. Allie gets hit? No, Candice gets hit. 86% match quality, but a 70 overall rating for Swan versus Sen. So this could be a good feud. This could be a good feud. So if Tamian gets to the main event, the next level could be pushing Rich Swan there as well for a nice feud. So 1-2-3 count gets and the victory. 68 for this. But 77 match quality, so this could be a good mid card feud. Kenta lost overness from getting attacked by Chavo, understandable. 71 for the Fatal 4-Way number one contenders match for the Knockouts Championship, which was won by Alicia Crawford. 73 for Alicia Crawford, then taunting Rebecca Knox on the microphone post-match. And the main event gets an 82, Ricochet and Nozlikar from their battles for NJPW in Japan. Rey Mysterio is the reigning TNA X Division champion and has been since 30th of August 2017. He's the newest champion in the company, as Kenta ensures the victory, or assures the victory, for Mysterio and Ricochet, who has made his return, the overall being a 7. Sort of disappointing. Not gonna lie, I'm sort of disappointed with that, but you know what? That just means that I gotta improve, gotta make it better, and things will go better. We're gonna finish the show, we're gonna read our emails. They signed Alex Riley. Big mistake. Tamatanga thinks she should be higher up the card, and so does Kenny. So the Bullet Club is already making demands, but you know what? I'll cave to their demands. So 71, he's an upper mid carder now. And Tamatanga, 63. Oh, alter position up. Tamatanga gets promoted. And let's add Tamatanga. Add new member. Let's add him to BC. So these are all the members from BC. Obviously Adam Cole, not a member in real life anymore, but you know, it is what it is. Do I not have Marty Scurll? Why do I not have Marty Scurll? I have Marty Scurll. And good. What show do I want him on? I have the Super Click on Explosion, so I should send non-impact, so I should send him to Explosion. Written. Yeah. He's gonna go to Explosion, so we got 3 members of the Bullet Club on Explosion, and three members of the Bullet Club on Impact. I'm gonna check and try to get him to team up with Tama Tonga, because you know Tangaloa isn't here. Stable. He shouldn't be in it. Team with that. Roster split. He goes to Explosion. Yeah. Stable. Add new member. Marty Scurll gets added. Now, obviously, I do have Cody Rhodes, and he is a member of the Bullet Club, but he joined the Bullet Club after I started the stable. After I had a stable here. So in this game, he's a babyface. He's not in the Bullet Club at all. He has no relation with the Bullet Club. And as a matter of fact, he was feuding with Adam Cole when Adam Cole decided to go to rehab. So, yeah. We could push Kenny Omega and Tama Tonga, which is nice because Tama Tonga just debuted, which is it's awesome that I got to push them. And yeah. Anyway, I think that'll do it for this episode. We got to do one show. We lost The Rock, but I think that's all. Yeah. The Rock is out. I don't know how to check who else isn't here. Search criteria. Oh, there we go. Contract type, nope. Roster split, nope. Positions. Okay, so injured. The Rock, yeah. I don't think anybody's suspended, no. And rehabbing. It's Adam Cole, Arya Davari, who was on Explosion, CM Punk, and Jeff Hardy. So, 3 members of Explosion and 1 member of Impact. Hopefully they'll return soon because I need them back. I need them back. Check the prestige. I need to raise this prestige up. This prestige is good. But yeah, we've had a lot of champions since the game started. Look at this history though. DJ Z, Ricochet, Brian Kendrick, Jeff Hardy, Rey Mysterio. It just kept going up and up, which is amazing. So yeah. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. That'll do it for this episode. Next episode will be Impact. I believe we have 2 more weeks or three more weeks, which means 6 more episodes until No Surrender, I believe will be on episode 70. So yeah, we got up until episode 69, 69, to build up to that. In the meantime, I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like, let me know what you think in the comments, subscribe if you want to see more. I am talking super fast. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in whatever I upload next. Bye!